Hey guys, welcome to vteachacademy.com, and here in this presentation we are going to discuss graphs on trigonometric function. And here in this video we are going to discuss a graph of trigonometric function called sine x under the interval minus pi to pi. So in order to discuss the graph of sine x, let us consider an equation, that is y equal to sine x under the interval minus pi to pi. And here we have to find the values of y corresponding to the different values of x in a table. So now let us draw a table here. So here there is a table. In the first row we are going to write the values of x, which are radians, which starts from minus pi. Then the next radian is 3 pi by 4. And then the next radian will be minus pi by 2. Then it is minus pi by 4. And then we have 0 degrees. Then pi by 4, then pi by 2, then 3 pi by 4, then pi. And here in the second row, we are going to write y equal to sine x. That is the value of y corresponding to the different values of x. So here by substituting the values of x in y, we get the values of y. So first, let us substitute the value 0 in the equation. So we get y equal to sine 0. So the value of sine 0 is 0. And then by substituting the value of pi by 4 in the equation, we get sine pi by 4. And the value for sine pi by 4 is 1 by root 2, which is approximately equal to 0.707. So here we get 0.707. And then the next radian is pi by 2. So by substituting that in y, we get sine pi by 2. And the value of sine pi by 2 is 1. And the next value is 3 pi by 4. So here we get sine 3 pi by 4, which is equal to sine 3 into 45 degrees, which is equal to sine 135 degrees. And here it can be written as sine 90 degrees plus 45 degrees. So here it is in the form of sine 90 plus theta, which is equal to cos theta. So here we get cos 45, and the value for cos 45 is 1 by root 2. So here we get 1 by root 2 as the value for sine 3 pi by 4, which is approximately equal to 0.707. And then we have pi, so sine 180 degrees is equal to 0. So we get here 0. And now let us find the value of y for negative radians. So here it is minus pi by 4, which is equal to minus of the value of plus pi by 4. So here we get minus of 0.707. And then minus pi by 2. So the value for sine minus pi by 2 will be equal to minus of sine pi by 2. So here we get minus 1 as the value. And then the next value is minus 3 pi by 4. So the value for sine minus 3 pi by 4 will be equal to minus of positive sine 3 pi by 4. So here we get minus of 0.707, and then the next radian is minus pi. So the value for sine minus 180 degrees is 0. And now let us plot all these points in a coordinate plane, and then by joining all these points we get a curve of sine x in the interval minus pi to pi. So first let us draw a coordinate plane, that is x-axis and a y-axis. So here the vertical line is y-axis, and this, which is the horizontal line, is x-axis. And now let us plot the values of x, that is radians, on x-axis. So first here we get a point, that is origin, where x-axis and y-axis intersect, and then the next radian is pi by 4, then we get pi by 2, then 3 pi by 4, and at last pi on positive x-axis. And now let us plot the scale on negative x-axis. So first we get here minus pi by 4, then minus pi by 2, then minus 3 pi by 4, and at last minus pi. Here on y-axis we get points as 0.7 and then 1. And now on negative y-axis we get minus 0.7 and minus 1. And now let us plot the values of y corresponding to the values of x. So here, for the value of x, that is minus pi, we get 0. So 0 lies on x-axis. We get a point over here. And then for minus 3 pi by 4, we get a point at minus 0.707. So we get a point somewhere here where minus 3 pi by 4 and 0.7 meets. And then the next radian is minus pi by 2. And its value is minus 1. So we get a point over here where minus pi by 2 and minus 1 intersects. So here we get a point. And then the next radian is minus pi by 4 and its value is minus 0.707. So we get a point somewhere here. And then the next point is for the value of x, that is 0, we get value of y as 0. So which is nothing but origin. So we get a point on the origin, that is somewhere here. And the next radian is pi by 4 and its value is 0.707. So we get a point over here. And then we have pi by 2 and its value is 1. So we get a point here where 1 and pi by 2 meets. So let us write a point over here. And then the next radian is 3 pi by 4 and its value is 0.707. So here somewhere we get point. So let us mark this point here. And then the next radian is pi and its value is 0. So hence 0 lies on x-axis, so we get a point on x-axis. And then by joining all these points, we get a graph. So here this graph is called as y equal to sine x under the interval minus pi to pi. So hope you understood the concept. Do like and subscribe to vteachacademy.com. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day.